My name is Samson Alemu. I'm from Tour Biotech. So I think to be inclusive, I will use English as most of my presentation language, but I will mix Amharic too. So thank you so much. Let me start with our motto. Our motto is life. We feed life with life. So Ethiopian farmers have been facing significant challenge in terms of agricultural inputs. So especially in terms of fertilizers, it's been a huge problem for the agriculture sector itself. So the first thing is shortage of agricultural inputs. When we see this picture, so sorry for the inconvenience. So shortage is the first thing. So when we see this picture, the first picture shows that farmers asking for fertilizers in the region of in the Amhara region, the agricultural office bureau. So it's been a real challenge, and they managed to come to the office and ask even for the supply. This year, in 2022, the report that FAO recently reported that only 40% of the total demand was covered. So it's shortage is one of the biggest issue currently, and the second thing is like low productivity. Agricultural productivity have been significantly dropping in recent years. There is a drop in productivity of 5.5% in every crop, and in cereal crops, which is our main focus, 7.5% every year. It's a huge loss. So it's due to the use of different chemicals. It's due to the effect of climate change. And also soil acidity is the biggest issue that we are facing currently. 48% of the total arable land, and which is causing 50% loss in productivity. Also, the price is very unaffordable for smallholder farmers whose income is below 1,000. So it's really expensive. 100% increase in urea and 150% increase in DAP since 2018. So different stakeholders, including the Ministry of Agriculture and other stakeholders, have been trying different things to solve this issue. They have implemented different projects. They have tried to import chemical fertilizers in bulk. They try to involve farmers to use their own composting system. But it has been less effective in terms of mitigating this problem. So here we come up with a different way of different approach to solve this problem. We decided to explore the micro world. So we will use microorganisms as a source of nutrient for crops. So our product is called inoculums. Inoculums are living organisms. Once they enter the soil, they will provide the necessary nutrients for the plant. So they are living organisms that will provide nutrients to the plant. So the advantage of these products is they will improve productivity by 20 to 30%. It boosts disease and drought resistance of the crop. And also it's required in a minimal amount. We will be able to cover 1 hectare with 1 to 1.5 kg, which is a very small amount compared to the 200 up to 250 kg used when they use chemical fertilizers, and when they use compost, they will use almost 15,000 kg of compost. So, which is a huge, really for the farmers. It also has affordable price because it doesn't require a complex production process. It has affordable price. It will help the soil to rehabilitate. It will improve the biological system in the soil. It will also provide a germination rate of 90%, which is very high compared to the country average of 75% right now. So we have three products. They are suitable for different crop types. So the first one is called Ors NC. So it's for cereal crops and grains, and the second one is for leguminous crops, and the third one is called urspaga. It's for all types of crops, and it's a combination of 7 different types of bacteria. So it will provide all the necessary nutrients. So here is how the farmers are going to use. They can use it alone, or they can use it by mixing with the chemical fertilizer called DAP or diammonium phosphate. When they use it alone, it will bring productivity increment of 20 to 30%, and also it will allow them to sell with a very good price, because organic products are very expensive these days. And when they use it with DAP, it's obviously increase the productivity to 60 to 70%, which is a huge amount in terms of productivity too. But in terms of being organic, it's something that we don't recommend farmers to use. So here is this image shows that how the farmers are going to use. So before they start throwing the seeds, they have to treat the seeds with our products. They have to soak the seeds with our products so that the bacteria will infect the seeds and grow together when we throw them. So it needs 30 minutes before we throw them, so that the bacteria will incorporate it inside the soil. So let me see the let me show you the comparison with chemical fertilizer in the compost or other organic fertilizers. So they are very expensive. Chemical fertilizers that nowadays farmers are they are charging from 7,000 Ethiopian birr to 11,000, and with our products they will only cost, it will only cost 700, between 700 and 1,000, which is a huge profit for the farmers. It also the chemical fertilizers are also used in bulk, and even compost also uses much bulk use. And also chemical fertilizers are low accessibility. Organic fertilizer ochim and you but am tedious on a production process ne yallacho keza betechamari demo and you expensive enough. የኛ ግን relatively easy on a production process ne yallo keza betechamari small amount ነው የሚያስፈልገው እንዳልኳችሁ so ብዙ save ለማድረግ ይጠቅማቸዋል. Chemical fertilizer, they are better productive but they are inorganic, so they are not healthy. They will gradually deteriorate the soil. So organic, but there is no immediate impact when you sow the organic fertilizer. So it's also one good side and one bad side. But we try to harmonize the market, high productivity. Now organic on a product, you know, is an imetano, malas no. So our products also have immediate impact. So it's better in every aspect of the measure of fertilizers. So far we have been field trials in 14 places and greenhouse trials in Addis Ababa Science and Technology University. We have done field trials in these places. So this was the relativity, the average productivity that we get. This is the comparison. So there was an average of 20 to 30% productivity increase. We are also licensed by the Ethiopian Biodiversity Institute. አንዳንድ ኮሌክቶር አካባቢ ከፈጀ ፕሮሰስ በኋላ የኤክስፐርት አስተያየት የነሱም ቴስቲንግ ተጨምሮበት ከዛ በኋላ ከኢትዮጵያ ስታንዳርድ ኤጀንሲ ጋር በመሆን ፕሮዳክቶቹን ወደ ማርኬት እንድናወጣ ከኢትዮጵያ ባዮዳይቨርሲቲ ኢንስቲትዩት ጋር አግሪመንት ሳይን አድርገን ሶ 2% እነሱ ፕሮፊት ሼር ይወስዱና ወደ ማርኬት የምንወጣበት ሁኔታ ላይ ደርሰናል ማለት ነው። አሁን ከዛ በተጨማሪ ግሎባል ግሪን ግሮዝ ኢንስቲትዩት የአመቱ ቤስት ሎካል ክላይሜት ቼንጅ አዳፕታቢሊቲ ፕሮጀክት ተብለን ተሸልመናል። ሶ ማርኬቲንግ ፓርትነርስ እና ታርጌትድ ኤሪያችን ይሄንን በተለይ ከትሬኒንግ በኋላ ያስተካከልነው ነው በብዛት። ሶ እነዚህ ኤሪያዎች ለስ ሪዚስታንስ ይገጥመናል፣ አዲስ ቴክኖሎጂ ከመሆኑ ጋር ተያይዞ ለስ ሪዚስታንስ ይገጥመናል ብለን ያሰብንባቸው። ከዛ በተጨማሪ ከፍተኛ የሆነ አግሪካልቸራል ፕሮዳክቲቪቲ ያለባቸው ከፍተኛ የሆነ የኢሪጌሽን ሲስተም ያለባቸው ቦታዎች ናቸው። ሶ እንደመጀመረ እነዚህ ኤሪያዎች ላይ ኖርዝ ሸዋ፣ አርሲ ዞን፣ ኢስት ጎጃም፣ አሶሳ ዞን እና ሲዳማ ዞን እንደመጀመሪያ መግቢያ ለመጠቀም አስበናል ማለት ነው። እንደ ፕሮሞሽን እስካሁንም ስናደርግ የነበረው ዲሞ ሳይቶችን መጠቀም ነው። አሁንም ዲሞ ሳይቶችን መጠቀም እንቀጥላለን። we will also use influential farmers We will use extension workers, agriculture, Minister of Agriculture Gamis are extension workers, and now door-to-door promotion. ለትልልቅ ለኮመርሻል ፋርሞች እንጠቀማለን ብለን አስበናል. The sales and the farmer unions and cooperatives, retail shops, እና የራሳችን ሾፖችም እንዲሁም ደግሞ አሁን recently የኢትዮጵያ agricultural transformation institute የጀመራቸው one stop ሾፖች እንጠቀማለን ብለን እናስባለን. So almost that's 3.2 million ብር አካባቢ የሚሆን ኢንቨስትመንት ኮስት አለው. እንደምታዩት እንደዚህ አይነት ብሬክዳውን አለው. ወርኪንግ ካፒታል ኢኩዊፕመንት እና other expenses ጀነራላይዝ ለማድረግ ሞክሬያለሁ. So በዚህ ብር we will have 90 ቶን በአመት የማምረት ካፓሲቲ ይኖረናል. ግን ማርኬቱን እየገባን ለማየት ያክል በዚህ አመት 50 ቶን ፐር ኢየር ለማምረት ነው ያቀድነው. So ከዛ ጋር ተያይዞ ወርኪንግ ካፒታላችን ትንሽ ጥቅ ያለው በዛ ምክንያት ነው. So almost 55% of productivity አቅማችን ነው የምንጠቀመው ማለት ነው. So ይሄን ተጠቅመን 16,850,000 ብር profit ይኖረናል እና ከ75,000 በላይ small holder farmers እንደርሳለን ብለን እናስባለን. Thank you so much. እስካሁን 27 ሄክታር የሚሆን commercial farmers ጋር agreement ፈርመናል supply ለማድረግ ለሚቀጥለው አመት. ከዛ በተጨማሪ ወደፊት ምንሄድበት መንገድ የተወሰነ ለመናገር ያክል ከዚህ በኋላ እኛ ከምንሰራቸው ሪሰርቾች በተጨማሪ ከኢትዮጵያ ግብርና ምርምር ኢንስቲትዩት እንዲሁም ከባዮና ኢመርጂንግ ቴክኖሎጂ ኢንስቲትዩት ጋር ኦልሬዲ አግሪመንቶች ፈርመናል. ሶ የነሱንም ኮመርሻላይዝ ወደ ማድረግና ባዮሎጂካል ፕሮዳክቶችን ለመጠቀም እና የግብርና ችግራችንን ለመፍታት እንሞክራለን. ቴንክ ዩ ሶ ማች አመሰግናለሁ.